Very good morning to everyone. In this lecture, EC8652 Wireless Communication, today we are going to discuss about the topic Error Performance in Fading Channels. Now, the error probability in flat fading channels are discussed in this session. The average bit error probability has to be computed. The received signal power is not maintained as a constant level. It changes when the fading of the channel changes. So, in the fading channel of the bit error rate will decreases linearly with the signal to noise ratio. In the additive white Gaussian noise channels, it will decrease exponentially. The value of the signal to noise ratio will change. The bit error rate and the signal to noise ratio is relationship is non-linear. Then the linear average error probability, the Q function is defined as a Q of x equal to 1 by 2 pi integral of x to infinity. It is a exponential of minus t square divided by 2 into dt. So, in this value is applied in the computation of the bit error rate. So, the Q of x, the expression can be rearranged, the Q of x equal to 1 by 2 pi integral of 0 to pi by 2. In the exponential components is the same. So, the bit error rate, and then we can find out the bit error rate. First of all, we can discuss the why the reason of errors. So the errors in the wireless communication in propagation channels, the transmission errors are caused by signal distortions. They are initiated by delay dispersion and frequency dispersions. If data rate is higher, then the delay dispersion is dominant. But a lower data rate, the Doppler effect will induce the distortions. In rise in transmit power will not lead to reduction in the bit error rate value. These errors also called the irreducible errors using the diversity or equalization technique at the receiver side. These errors can be reduced. Now we can move to the bit error rate in the fading channels. So this is a basic structure of the binary receiver side. So x of t is one of the modulated input signal, and the n0 of t, and the low pass filter, that is a low pass filter h of f, and then the signal is sampled by the sample and hold circuits, and then it threshold the value of, and we can find out the output signal. So this is a binary received to find out the estimation of the bit error rate. The signal x of t is a digital signal summation of k alpha k p of t minus kt. This is the amplitude modulated pulse signal. This signal is affected by additive white Gaussian noise in the channel and is then input to the receiver. The first block in the receiver is a low pass filter that eliminates the part of the input noise with preceding the inter symbol interference. It gives the signal of y of t. The receiver takes synchronized sample of the signal and generate the after the sampled and hold operation is random variable of form of y of t k is equal to a k plus n of t k. This is a continuation of the bit error rate in the fading channels. The receiver take the synchronized samples of the signal and generate the after sample and hold operation a random variable of the form of signal y of t k, that is a different time period. So the a k plus n of t k, so here the sampled values y of t k constitute a random variable y, and noise samples n of t k take from a random signal n of t from a random variable n. In this lowest complexity decision rules for deciding the received binary values is the hard decisions, which consist only for comparing the sampled value y of tk with a threshold u such that if y of tk greater than u, then the receiver considered the transmitted bit is a 1, and y of tk less than u, the signal y of t is converted into a signal x of t. It basically of the same kind of the expression in the equations. It apparently noise free signals, but possible containing the some errors with respect to the original transmitted signal. The probability of density function of the random variable y is related to the noise and to conditional probability of the transmitted symbol. So it can be identified or relevanted to H0 is the hypothesis that a 0 was transmitted, AK is equal to 0 and then Y is equal to N. And H1 is the hypothesis that a 1 was transmitted, AK is equal to A, YK is equal to A plus 1. The probability density function of the random variable Y continuation on the even H0 is given by. Now, the probability density functions of the random variable y conditions on each H0 is given by Py of y into H0 is equal to Pn of y. Pn of y is nothing but the Gaussian probability density functions with hypothesis x1. So the hypothesis x1 is nothing but the py of y h1 is equal to pn of y minus a. This is the probability density functions in the case is shifted to the value of n equal to y minus a. Thus the probability density function for the noisy signals is probability density functions for noise free discrete signal 0 or unipolar format. The density function of the noise Pn of n and also the probability density function of each signal in the Gaussian probability density function centered at the value of the amplitude that is transmitted. Now the another one example of the probability of errors associated with each hypothesis. The receiver assumed that the y less than u, the hypothesis H0 has occurred. The error in this probability associated with the equal threshold value in the conventional of the medium, spectral medium. The threshold value u closer to the amplitude 0 reduced the error probability associated with the symbol of duration 1. But it increased the error probability associated with symbol 0, it is low. So the common probability of error in the transmission is an average over these two error probabilities. It now calculated to estimate the threshold conditions of the signal. So the transmission symbol 0 and 1, the average error probability is precedes the mean value of the error in the transmission that takes into the account of the probability of the occurrence of each symbols. It derivative the with respect to the threshold u of the average error probability is the set to be equal to 0 to determine the optimal value of the threshold conditions. So the optimal value of the threshold value in the middle of the two amplitude symbol of the bit durations. So in this performance in the feeding channels is the reason for the errors and also the frequency dispersions. Due to the frequency dispersion error will occur in the signal propagation, it is expected that whatever errors would occur, and the instantaneous frequency shift may take place. It is larger than the Doppler frequency, and also fading tips will lead to larger Doppler shift. If the Doppler shift is the finite, then the channel does change. In case of minimum shift keying, the estimated bit error due to the Doppler effect is average Doppler bit error is equal to 1/2 1-tb. And then the error performance in the delayed dispersion of fading channels. The symbol, the system is with high data rates, the delay dispersion effect are significant. The excessive delay of the channel impulse response is found by the environment in error floor due to the delay dispersions. So in this kind of error in the delay dispersion of the channels, the average bit error ratio is equal to k into s tau divided by t b. Here the s tau is nothing but the RMS delay spread of the channels. Now the performance of these errors will be point outed in the conical receiver. The receiver structure, it can be reduced the signal multiplied with the reference signal at one time with a normal signal, and the another time it is shifted by the pi by 2 signal, and a quadrature components of are obtained. As a result, the signal is filtered with a low pass filter and is sent to the decision device. The Cochran detection or differential detection, it can be applied to eliminate the carrier at the receiver end. In this, received signal components from low pass filter are R1 of t, that is R I of t and R Q of t, in space or out of phase, or in space or quadrature components, are passed through the decision device, the output is taken. So the overall conclusion of these performance of the errors in the faded channels, the bit error ratio is calculated and the sequence of the steps are followed. What are the different sequence? Step number one, the received structure can be reduced to canonical form. And second one, formulating the conditions for occurring of errors. Third one, computation of mean and correlation coefficient. Third one, computation of bit error rate for MSK and DPSK channels. So we can find out the bit error rate, that is accurate bit error rate, and particularly in the railing fading channels. Thank you for watching this video.